the reality of a global disaster, in which martial law is declared. Life-threatening factors. The National Guard. Imagine the National Guard being called out to protect us. At first they would be okay, until you ran out of supplies. They are put in place to make sure that you stay put and starve to death. If you confront them, you will be indefinitely incarcerated. If you engage them, they will shoot back. Cities. People will exodus from the depleted cities, out into the country suburbs and rural areas, scavenging and foraging. The closer you are, the faster the desperate people will want your food. At some point, you will become the desperate and you'll need to get your hands dirty to get supplies. Scavengers. The scavengers will take everything you have that is of value. They will kill you for something as little as your toilet paper. Waving a gun won't do it. You'll have to take one or two down quickly to show the rest that you mean business. Things you will need. Shelter for security. A strong defense is a good offense. An impenetrable fortress will help keep out the bad guys. Minimize openings. Weapons. A gun is a must. Without one or more, the scavengers will take everything you have that is of value. You'll need one for when it's your turn to become a scavenger. Water. You're going to need clean water. Without it, you're dead in 3 days. 8 drops of bleach per gallon, or a rolling boil, for 5 minutes should do the trick. Food. Food should be high on your list. 3 days without food, and your body metabolism will change to emergency mode, and start burning your muscles and body fat at the same rate. Maybe 3 weeks, then you're done. Be prepared. Stockpile food and goods and other essential items to keep you alive and safe.